Please be seated. In your bulletins, the call to worship. I will call to mind the deeds of the Lord. I will remind you your wonders of old. I will meditate on all your work and muse on your mighty deeds. Your way, O God, is holy. What God is so great as our God? You are the God who works wonders. You have displayed your might among the peoples. Let us worship God.
Good morning. We will boast of your presence among us, O God, and magnify your holy name. You still the avenger. You bring low the mighty. You exalt the humble and forget not your own. We are privileged to be numbered among those you have chosen, and through Christ seek you, honor you in all that we can do. Hear our praises, which we raise before you, as in glad adoration our tributes we bring.
Please join me in the prayer of confession found in your bulletin. God of freedom, set at liberty we who are captive, and grant us absolution as we confess our sin. Prisoners of self-interest, we disregard neighbors. We bolster our own egos at others' expense. When slander is rampant, we seldom stop it. When rumors are rife, we seek not the source. Help us to check our destructive ways, lest we consume one another and cause us to use our freedom more loving ways.
The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against such things. We who belong to Jesus Christ have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. Therefore, let us live in love and bear one another's burdens in the assurance that we are forgiven and made alive in the Spirit.
The peace of God be with you. Greet one another in peace.
We had a fun week at VBS this week. Our theme was King DeBrock, Standing Strong for God. There were approximately 135 children, many teachers and helpers, lots of fun and games, activities, and exciting Bible lessons. Each day, we learned the importance of standing strong for God. On Monday, our Bible memory verse was Psalm 18:1. I love you, Lord. You are my strength. Together, we learn that God's love helps us stand strong. We should rely on God to guide us and help us make good choices. Our job is to bring honor to God's name in all we do.
Bible memory verse was 1 Thessalonians 5:11. So encourage each other and build each other up. Together we learn that family and friends help us stand strong. We know that there are many temptations and difficulties in life. We learn to look to friends and family to help us stand strong in our faith during these hard times.
Let's go!
Wednesday, our Bible memory verse was Philippians 4:6. Don't worry about anything, instead pray about everything. Together we learned that prayer helps us stand strong. We learned that even though we are very busy with school, sports, and other activities, we need to make time to pray. Prayer is a powerful tool to help us stay in tune with God's plans for our lives. On Thursday, our Bible memory verse was Isaiah 26:4. Trust in the Lord always, for the Lord God is the eternal rock. Together we learned that trusting God helps us stand strong. We learned that obedience can be hard for both kids and adults. It's tempting to just give up, do things an easier way, or even ignore what God wants us to do. If we trust God's plan and stand strong in our faith, our lives will be changed forever. On Friday, our Bible memory verse was Psalms 119:105, your word is a lamp to guide my feet and a light for my path. Together we learn that the Bible helps us stand strong. In this age of Google, smartphones, and other portable information devices, it is easy to get answers to our questions 24/7 each day. Another important source of answers is our Bible, God's holy word. Even though the Bible was written a very long time ago, it is the ultimate source of answers. It is timeless, a great guide to life, full of encouraging messages, challenging, and gives our lives hope. In order for our faith to keep getting stronger, we need to explore the Bible every day.
Stand strong in the ups and downs. Stand strong for your
I first need to apologize. Our delay in getting the VBS program started, I'd love to blame it on some piece of hardware, but it was me. I'm getting confused about which one was the mute button. So when you have the mute button on, there's not a lot of sound. So that was my fault. But we wanted to thank Amy Lawson for organizing Vacation Bible School this year. We want to thank everyone who donated food, materials, and money to make this week possible. A special thanks goes to all the teachers, crew leaders, and kitchen helpers. Without you, this would not have been possible. We thank the Presbyterian Church for its generosity in making this community outreach possible. And we thank the parents of the children who attended this year. We are grateful for the opportunity to teach your children to stand strong for Jesus. We look forward to seeing you all again next year. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for the opportunity of having VBS. We thank you for all the individuals who donated time and resources so that we could have this VBS week. And we thank you, Lord God, for all the children, all the gifts and talents and abilities and the unique creation you made each one of them. We thank you, Lord God, for spending time with us. And we pray, Lord God, that your blessings will be upon them forever and ever. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. All righty. Now we will stand and sing hymn number 589, Here I Am, Lord. VBS Sunday, but Confirmation Sunday. And we have a number of individuals who have worked long and hard with their teacher, Gene Shibley, in going through classes and learning a lot of things. And ultimately, they had to make presentations to session about their faith and about what they believe. And so they have gone through that process, and we are very proud that they did and that this day has come. So I'd like to ask the confirmants to please come forward. We'll stand down here because we're a little crowded up here. Do you want to go from the pulpit? Okay. She's going to be loud. All right. Hear the words of our Lord Jesus Christ. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit. Everyone who acknowledges me before people, I will also acknowledge before my Father who is in heaven. Friends, Jesus Christ has chosen you and in baptism has joined you to himself. He has called you together with us into the church, which is his body. Now he has brought you to this time and place so you may confess his name before men and go out and serve him as faithful disciples. And now we have just a few questions. Emily and Emma, Cole and Trace. Who is your Lord and Savior? Do you trust in him? So answer, I do. Do you intend to be his disciple, to obey his word, and to show his love? Will you be a faithful member of the congregation, giving yourself in every way? And will you seek the fellowship of the church wherever you may be? If so answer, we will. Emily and Emma, Cole and Trace. You are a disciple of Jesus Christ. He has commissioned you. Live in his love and serve him and be filled with gratitude. Let the message of Christ dwell among you in all its richness. Whatever you are doing, whether you speak or act, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father through him. I'd like to ask the congregation to join in the prayer found in your bulletin. Oh God, our Father, we praise you for calling us to be a servant people and for gathering us into the body of Christ. We thank you for choosing to add to our number brothers and sisters in faith. Together may we live in your spirit and so love one another that we may have the mind of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom we give honor and glory forever. Amen. Please be seated. Today we are celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion, and the Presbyterian Church has an open communion. All who believe that Jesus Christ is their Lord and Savior are free to take and join in with us in celebrating in this holy sacrament. And so let us prepare our hearts and minds to receive this sacrament. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now let us pray the prayer our Lord and Savior taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. On the night our Lord was betrayed, he took bread. And he broke it, and he said, This is my body broken for you. As often as you eat this, do so in remembrance of me. And in like manner, he took the cup, and he said, This cup is the new covenant in my blood. As often as you drink this, do so in remembrance of me. And as often as we eat from this bread and drink from this cup, we do proclaim his death until he comes. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith. body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Thank you. the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Are there any announcements that anyone has at this time? We've got a yes. We've got a reception after church downstairs with some cake for the for the confirmants and the VBS kids. So please come down and join us. Any other pertinent concerns? Yes. What was his name? Okay. Anyone else? Okay. And let us gather together as God's people in prayer. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you so much for our ability to come before you and to pray to you. We thank you, Lord God, for all the things that you've done for us, for the blessings that we recognize, and for the so many that we simply don't remember or take notice of. We thank you for your continued grace and mercy. We pray, Lord God, that your Spirit will be upon each one of us and that you will lead us in the path that you would have us go. You will guide us in the ways that you would have us seek, and that you would bless us as we seek to serve you and to glorify your name. We pray this day, Lord God, for those individuals who are hurting and struggling, those who've been in accidents, those who are suffering from illness. Let us take a few moments to pray for those we're concerned about. Lord God, we thank you for hearing our prayers for others. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Please join me in the prayer of dedication. O God, you cast your mantle upon us and mark us for ministry in Christ's name. We come before you with our tithes and offering. We shall put on your cloak of righteousness, a sign of nations of how you redeem all people. We shall carry the cross of salvation to the far corners of the globe. Accept these gifts as tokens of our commitment and bless our endeavors as we serve in Christ's name.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and to be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, now and forevermore. Amen.